with my weight mat. And I look off to the north and there's a funnel cloud dropping down.
From his Emmanuel Hospital bed, Tom Hannon remembers what he saw from the seat of his big rig in Memphis, Tennessee on February 5th.
And I wasn't real sure at first. And then I seen the blue lightning, which is the power lines pop. And then I knew for sure it was a tornado.
At that moment, Hannon had been talking to his girlfriend back in Carter Lake.
The sound, that roaring sound, though, I was like, you gotta go inside, you gotta go inside.
Hannon ran inside this building, the warehouse he was parked at in Memphis. Our CNN affiliate, WMC-TV, provided this video.
As I'm standing there, everything starts coming down. The ceiling's falling in on me. And within seconds, the door that I'm standing under, it all collapsed and everything comes right down on my hips. It just crushes me underneath.
The debris crushed Hannon's pelvis. He suffered internal injuries and lost a lot of blood.
I heard a lady screaming, help me, help me, help me. And so I thought, well, do as the Joneses do. So I said, help me, help me, help me too.
He doesn't know how long he was buried before a firefighter found him. Three others were crushed to death inside.
The next day when I woke up out of surgery, I found out that the lady that was next to me had passed away, along with two other people that were in their building.
Hannon has a long road of recovery ahead of him. It'll be at least 3 months before these wiggling toes become feet that will walk again. But he's back home. His girlfriend and mother are at his bedside, and he's grateful he's alive.
I could be dead. I could have a leg missing, but I'm not. I'm very thankful for the way I ended up.
With more complete coverage, Brandi Peterson, KETV NewsWatch 7.